So here we have the Crua Outdoors Duo. This is a two-person tent, although this is a huge two-person tent. It's not terribly heavy. I want to say roughly in the 5-pound range, but it is certainly not a lightweight option, but a very capable and sturdy tent. It took me a little bit of effort to get this set up in here simply because of my space constraints, but it is not difficult at all to set up. And overall, actually, just in an initial glimpse, I am pretty impressed at how this looks. I like the headspace. It is very high. If you see here, a very nice ample headspace. And then here on the outside of the tent, I mean, the inside is plenty spacious for two people. But then on top of that, you end up with this extended vestibule design, which is very interesting. It actually is going to add a good amount of overall length to this, but it is outside of the bathtub, so you will end up basically with a floorless vestibule. But overall setup, I'd say took me maybe 12 minutes inside for the first time, having never pulled this out. And again, that's simply because of my overall space constraints and the length of the poles and stuff, and my need to kind of work around it just a little bit. And you'll see, I mean, I'm quite tight to this. I can back up a little bit, but then my furniture and stuff starts to get into the frame. So overall, my initial impression of this is that it appears to be a very nice fabric. Taking a look at the stitching, nicely done. The presentation is great. All the tie-outs are just well done and organized and already fashioned to the tent, so they've done a nice job with that. Everything was packaged up beautifully inside here. Came with the setup instructions, which I pretty much ignored. But I also did watch a few videos on this, so I already kind of knew what to expect. One of the things that had me just a little bit confused was basically where I do not have this vestibule extended out. There are some of these kind of toggles here to hold back different doors. There's a lot going on here with the zipper design and how many zippers and toggles there are to hold back all the components that make up the front of the tent. However, that's basically my fault. I do not have the ability to stake this out right now, and by doing that, it kind of simplifies things and exposes what's going on under here. But overall, this looks like it's going to be a very interesting tent. I wonder if it's going to be kind of on the warm side for the summer. I mean, that's my first impression when you look in here. This is a screenless tent design. You do have a couple of vents, and you do have overall the screen in the front, but generally speaking, you do not have a rain fly. It is a one-piece sort of outer layer, so you do not end up with a separate rain fly over the top here. And in that regard, you have no windows, and you do, like I said, have these vents, but not a ton in the way of overall ventilation. So I think it'll be a little bit limiting for a cross breeze, that's for sure. And I just wonder if it's going to be a little bit warm for the summertime. I think my initial impression, this would be a wonderful tent for the spring, I would say early spring. And certainly well into the fall and maybe into the early winter months. But I just am a little bit concerned with the overall heat and humidity in the summertime. Now, the floor of the tent feels to be extremely durable. I am not intending on bringing this with a tarp or anything to go beneath it, so I'm solely relying on the quality of the floor and this bathtub floor to keep me both dry but also to protect the tent. You know, a lot of times when you get into the woods, I'm going to be in a mountainous area when I use this. A lot of times there's, you know, twigs and sticks and rocks and roots and different debris. One of the things that does kind of bug me about when you do not use a footprint is the fact that pine needles and sappy things all stick to the bottom of the tent. I'm going to kind of just say, well, it is what it is, and I'm going to live with it. I believe that for me, this tent is one that I would certainly use without a footprint for two reasons. One is the overall size and weight of the tent to begin with. It's already not a lightweight design. It's a little bit large and oversized. It's much bigger than a typical two-man tent. But then the other piece of it is the overall thickness and durability, and then the sort of water repellent feeling of the base of this. So I'm really taking, I'm not going to say a gamble, but I'm relying solely on the tent to do the work here and not a footprint. Now, I've heard some people talk about the advantage of this tent being the fact that it does stay quite dark, even into the morning. So you get a good night's sleep and you can sleep well into the morning without it being too bright. I think that seems to make sense. So we'll see how that is, not having the screen or really the windows on here. And I'm hoping that popping up these vents is going to be enough to let the moisture out. Now, looking through here, everything is taped extremely well, just very well taped right on the seams. You end up with a little hook here, which will be beautiful for hanging a lantern. You have some pockets in strategic locations, one on each side, which is good. No other pockets from what I can see. Back here is just a little ventilation. So down low, you do end up with some ventilation. So inlet of cool air, outlet of the warmer and moist air. So you should get a little bit of circulation through here. So I think that is definitely going to work, and the advantage to having that vent down low. And then also you would obviously have the ability to leave the screen open in the front. So I mean, technically I would leave the screen shut, but you know, leaving the vestibule area wide open to allow some airflow. Now, if you notice, there is a little bit of Velcro on the front of this bathtub floor. I'm not exactly sure what that's for. I didn't notice when I had this set up if there was really something that the Velcro was used to hold down. So that's something I'm going to have to look at. Just an observation that there is some Velcro on the front of the floor. Now, this was relatively easy to set up overall, even though I had a space constraint in my living room here. Pretty simple design where the poles just go into these grommets up through these dedicated sleeves. There are two different sizes of pole, so the longer poles being made up the main crisscross across the top of the tent through these sleeves, and then with these little clips to hold these on, and then the shorter pole being used for the front of the vestibule. And so once you have everything sort of tied out and staked out and really taut, it gives you this overall beautiful shape. I am quite intrigued by the overall shape of this, and I think it's going to be a nice overall tent for many different conditions and seasons. And so I'm really looking forward to getting this thing out into the field and giving it some good quality use. So I'd just like to say thank you very much to the people at Crua Outdoors. I am a formal ambassador for the company at this point, and I very much appreciate the opportunity. I'm looking forward to working with you on product development and testing the stuff out and providing good quality feedback and hopefully recommendations to other people who are looking to get some quality gear for backpacking and camping application. And so the next time you're going to see this, it will be out in the field, hitting up the mountains and getting out there to enjoy this gear. So again, thank you, Crua, and everybody else. We'll see you out there.